So everyone feel comfortable with that?
Yep.
All right, so the next thing we're going to be doing is called the cookie cutter. Now this involves not picking up your feet at all. You guys can bring it in. Bring it in a little bit. So for the cookie cutter, we're going to start with our heels together. We're going to go out, and we're going to form a perfect little circle. So you start out, bring them in. You need a little momentum. Bring it out, bring it in. Bring it out. Okay, can you demonstrate that for everyone, please? Start with your hands together. Bring it out. Bring it up. You just do it this way, too, so I can get a better angle on it. Nice circle. Nice circle. But hey, if you keep this to your date, they might even think you know how to cut. So the next thing, everyone feels comfortable with that. They feel like that. For time's sake, we're going to skip over this drill and get right to the next step. Just stop it. Now stopping, obviously, is an important aspect of ice skating because anybody can skate fast once they get the hang of it, but not everyone can stop. So there's two forms of stopping we're going to learn today. One is called pizza stop. Now, who here skis? Anyone ski? Alright, so how do you stop and ski? Exactly, you want to form a little pizza triangle and have your feet inward. So everyone get your feet together right now like this. You gotta have your knees bent, nice comfortable balance. Knees bent, guys. Feel comfortable? Alright. Next one is called the T-stop. Now, why do you think it's called the T-stop, Ryan? You form a T with your feet, exactly. The back foot is gonna be the plowing foot. So what this means is as we're skating, we're gonna be plowing the ice with our back foot. So can everyone position their feet like that for me real fast? Exactly like that, Mark. There you go. Alright, so for this next drill, we're going to do the same thing. We're going to glide down, push and glide down to that end. But when we get to the end, instead of grabbing onto the wall, we want to use either the pizza stop or the T-stop, whatever you feel most comfortable with. And you might want to have your stronger skater go first, so that when the second skater comes down, if they need a little help, we can give them a little support. Alright, so we're going to get back in our lines, we're going to work on our stop now. We're going to do the same thing. Yourself, and we're gonna come back with our partners. Alright, so first person up. First person up, ready, go. Whatever's most comfortable for you is how you want to stop. Everyone has their own skating style.
Last night.
Not bad.
Ben. So 30 seconds, guys. 30 seconds. Push each other up. About 10 to 15 yards away, you want to start thinking about how you're going to stop. Now, the reason we're doing the heart rate monitors is because we're going to take your resting heart rate, and your ending heart rate, and see how hard you guys work today. So we'll be watching, so make sure you work hard. Another thing is, when you're nervous, what happens? Your heart starts beating, right? So around this day, you don't want to make it apparent to your significant other that you're nervous. Now today, we're going to cool all that off, be confident to go next Friday night, right? Alright, so for the last ending part, we're going to have a little fun. We're going to get some music going. And once again, we're going to go around the cones with your partner, linked arms this time. Instead of the conga line, we're going to do linked arms and holding hands. Now, the important part about this is we want to see if you guys can uphold the conversation while skating. This will show that you're confident in your skating, but at the same time, you know that you can multitask while doing this. If you're on that date, once again, you want to be able to talk while also skating, right? Alright, so we're going to line up with our partners, starting at the purple. The Brian and his partner want to be first. You guys can follow behind him. And this way around the ice. Like I said, you want to go to the low reach speed because your partner might not have the same skill level as you. Oh, right. Okay. Once I hear the music, we're gonna start. All right, ready? Alright, so sorry the music didn't work, guys. I hope that would bring a little fun into it, but the speakers weren't working as planned, but we just had to flow with it. So what is one cue for stopping then? Knee or the T, very good. Your back foot does what, Kayla? Very good, flat. As you demonstrated. Now if we fall on our butt, we know how to properly get up, right? Anthony, can you demonstrate us?
Absolutely.
You don't have to actually.
Alright.
Let's turn over on all fours. One knee up, two hands, push off. Now cookie cutter. We don't want to pick up our feet. This is just for skate control. We want to form nice round cookies. Alright. So I hope you guys had fun today. Sorry we didn't get to the competitive part, but I think we're gonna get there next class. We're even gonna work on crossovers and backward skating. So when you go on the stage Friday night, you're gonna be able to show off the skills. Now for your homework, we want you to take your resting heart rate. Now you're gonna go compare it to your end heart rate, figure out the difference, and go home and you want to find your target heart rate and bring it back to the next class, alright? So I hope you guys had fun, because I know I did, and I hope you feel confident for that day Friday night. Thanks, guys.